Dynamic type is a system feature on iOS that lets users adjust the size of text on their devices. They can set their preferred text size in device settings and choose among regular text sizes or enable extra large accessibility sizes. Many iPhone users rely on this feature to make reading content easier, and we as developers need to ensure our apps adapt to the text size that users select. In this video, I'll share a few tips for supporting dynamic type in iOS apps built with SwiftUI. The easiest way to make text adapt to different sizes is to use SwiftUI's built-in text styles, such as title, headline, body, and others. These styles use the system font and automatically scale with the user's preferred text size. But we still need to test our apps for dynamic type support to check if our layout looks as expected. During development, we can quickly preview how individual views adapt by adjusting dynamic type size in the preview's device settings. For example, text that fits on one line in smaller text sizes might span across multiple lines when larger size is enabled. So we'll have to adjust the multi-line text alignment in some UIs. In general, it's best to avoid setting an explicit point size when using system fonts, unless there is a very specific UI requirement. Assigning a fixed size prevents the text from scaling dynamically with the user's preferred settings. Custom fonts, on the other hand, scale automatically when a size is specified. But we have to make sure that when we create a custom font, we use the function overload with the parameter name size and not fixed size. A custom font with a fixed size won't scale. Very often we can't guarantee that our interface will fully fit on screen when a larger text size is enabled. So it's usually a good idea to wrap our content into a scroll view to avoid clipping it or truncating. This way, when a large text size is set, users will be able to scroll to see everything. By default, wrapping a view into a scroll view adds a scroll bounce behavior, even when the entire UI fits on screen, for example, in smaller text sizes. But for some layouts, this bounce might not make sense when all elements are visible. To adjust the default scroll view behavior, we can use the scroll bounce behavior view modifier and set it to based on size. Then scrolling will only be enabled when the layout is large enough to overflow the screen size. When we use the default padding and spacing in SwiftUI, the system automatically updates their values based on the dynamic type size. But we can easily make custom padding or spacing dynamic as well. We just need to define the value using the ScaledMetric property wrapper. And SwiftUI will make sure it updates as text size changes. We can also use the ScaledMetric API to scale images with fixed width or height. SwiftUI will update the image frame and scale it up or down based on the text size. But we should only do that for images that add value to users, as it will cause the images to take up more of the screen space. For images that are purely decorative, we might even consider removing them in large accessibility sizes to free up more space for text. We can do it by reading the current dynamic type size from the environment and only showing the image if it's not an accessibility size, for example. These are just a few examples of what we can do to ensure that our apps adapt to user preferences and remain flexible to accommodate as many people as possible. For more SwiftUI tips and tutorials, check out our blog at nilcoalescing.com. Thank you for watching.